What's going on, friends? The twin cam engine had a lot of improvements over the Evo, but the stock crankshaft was definitely not a very good improvement over the Evo. The twin cam introduced in 1999 had stronger crankcases, it was more oil tight than the Evo, it had improved cooling, and increased power and displacement capabilities. Where Harley dropped the ball was the pressed together crankshaft. This wasn't a big issue from 1999 to 2002 with the 88, because the 88 had the Temkin bottom end. Now, in 2003, when they did away with the Temkin bottom end in favor of a pressed in roller bearing, that way they could just cut assembly costs by just putting it all together as one assembly, that is when the problems really started to show through with that pressed together crank. With the pressed together crank using that pressed in roller bearing, it did save Harley-Davidson money on production costs, but as bikes started getting out on the road, they started having issues with the cranks. And the issue with the cranks was they started seeing runouts as high as 30 thousandths. Now, ideally the runout needs to be about 2 thousandths or less, maybe 3 thousandths on the high side at most, especially if you want to go with some gear-driven cams. Now, I'm going to show you guys a diagram and kind of explain a little bit of what I'm talking about with this pressed together assembly, and we're going to take a look at what the issue is with it. Why does your runout get so high with this pressed together crank assembly? But before we get into all that, please be sure to give the video a like if you enjoy it, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Okay, so the left side of the flywheel here, this includes the spline shaft. Now, the right side of the flywheel includes the pinion shaft. The crank pin actually connects these two flywheel halves together. Now, this whole assembly, this entire assembly, is put together, and then Harley-Davidson compresses all of this together. The first issue is when this shaft is splined. I don't know how they spline it or when they spline it, but when it is splined, it alters the alignment of this left flywheel on the crank pin. The second issue is when this assembly is pressed together. Now, when this assembly is pressed together, and if either one of these two flywheels moves even just a little bit, either during the process of being pressed, assembled, run, doesn't matter when it happens, this is where you start to get that excessive run out over here on this pinion shaft. And when that happens, these two flywheel halves are not going to be running on the same plane on this crank pin. The other issue that can happen is that you've got this crank pin down here in the center that these two flywheel halves are on, and if either one of these flywheels rotates just a little bit on this crank pin, that is where you get into trouble. That's when your crank has spun. Now, this creates some excessive run out on that pinion shaft, and this can lead to some serious catastrophic engine failure. I mean, this could be really bad. This could take out your whole entire engine to the point to where even the block, none of it is going to be salvageable whatsoever. You're going to have to completely replace the engine. Pinion shaft wobble will damage your oil pump. It will damage your cams. It will damage your cam plate. And it'll also damage the entire cam drive system within your twin cam. Now, that doesn't, even if you have, it doesn't matter if you have chains. It doesn't matter if you have gears. It's going to tear everything up in there when you have that excessive run out and you got that crank wobbling in there. Now, to make matters even worse, when you have those damaged parts in there, those parts, little pieces of that, can actually circulate through the motor and they will destroy absolutely everything they touch. That includes your cylinder walls, your pistons, anywhere the oil touches, those little fragments floating around in there can potentially damage all of those parts, anything the oil touches. Now, there are some early warning signs though. Loud noises coming from the crankcase, the engine, ticking lifters, and also if you have excessive oil puking out of your head breathers, that's a pretty good indication that you've got something going on in there and it's not quite right. Also, you'll be noticing some excessive vibration. Well, what's excessive vibration for a Harley? Just, you're gonna feel that something's not right. Just trust me on that. It's not gonna feel good at all, and it's not gonna sound good either. So now, if you have oil coming out of your head breathers, you might have your oil tank overfilled. It is possible that the bike could be overfilled, so definitely check your oil first. But what happens with the pinion runout, if it damages, if you have excessive pinion runout from your crankshaft wobble, it's gonna damage the oil pump. And when it damages the oil pump, over time, what happens is, The scavenging side of the oil pump can't keep up with the feed side, and this causes oil to build up in the engine, and it's not getting circulated through the motor, so it has to go somewhere. And the easiest place for that oil to go is right out the head breathers. So that's a pretty good indication that you've got something really seriously wrong going on in there. Be sure to look for those signs on your motorcycle. And especially if you have your bike down and you have your cam chest opened up, whether you're doing a cam swap or you're doing some tensioner maintenance, just be sure to check the runout on that pinion shaft. Make sure it's not too crazy. I mean, Harley-Davidson says that acceptable levels for a pinion runout can be up to 12 thousandths. If you're getting some really wonky reading, like, you know, somewhere up around 20 to 30 thousandths in that range, check your dial gauge, have somebody else come and check it and verify it, but that's a good indication that your crank has spun, it's wobbling, and you've got a serious issue going on there. So also, if you have any of the signs that I just mentioned, don't ignore them, because you're headed down a bad road and you're looking at some catastrophic failure. Now, while the only true fix for this is to completely replace the crankshaft with an aftermarket piece such as from Dark Horse or S&S, you can take that factory crankshaft to a good qualified machine shop. They'll be able to pull it apart, actually balance the crankshaft. They'll be able to weld those flywheels to where they won't spin on there. And they can also true that crankshaft up. They'll have all the equipment and everything to do that, the correct stands and jigs, everything to fix that crankshaft properly. But you might want to weigh the cost between just buying a brand new crankshaft and what a machine shop's going to charge you to go ahead and true up your crank and make everything right. Now, it's a very crazy subject about these crank pins, because this doesn't happen to every single motorcycle. Now, true, adding horsepower, putting more power into the motorcycle can really exacerbate this issue and make it even worse. But once again, it doesn't happen to every bike. It's not uncommon, but it doesn't happen all the time. It's kind of like the twin cams, it's kind of like the cam chain tensioners on the 88s. Some bikes failed at 15,000 miles, other bikes have never had an issue. So I'm not trying to scare you off from a twin cam here. But there are some things that can accelerate wear, that can make these crankshafts spin. Yes, adding power into a motor with a stock crankshaft is one of them, but it also has to do with riding style. You know, if you're doing just constant hard acceleration on the bike, you're downshifting really hard, running those RPMs up, using a lot of engine braking, it's basically just abusing your motorcycle. And one of the biggest culprits of this is going out and doing what we all love to do, it's super awesome and fun, is burnouts. It's not only hard on the rear tire, but it's real hard on that crankshaft, especially the stock one that's pressed together. Now, if you are looking into putting some power into the bike, and if you've noticed with the Screamin Eagle kits, there is a required part called the Screamin Eagle Lefty Bearing. The Lefty Bearing has more needle bearings inside of it, and this is for your pinion shaft to help support that pinion side a little bit better, and it does help take out some of that wobble that can happen when you start really putting some power in the bike. But if you're going down that far with it to do that, there is another option for the 2003 and newer. They do have a sleeve where you can put a Timken tapered roller bearing in there, which is probably the best option if you're not gonna be doing anything with the crankshaft. Because having the Timken bearing in there, it's gonna give your crank better support and help reduce that wobble. Now for me personally, I love the twin cam engine. And like I said, I'm not trying to scare anybody about your twin cam, whether you already own one or you're looking at buying one. I'm not saying run out and hang a for sale sign on your bike. I just want you to be aware of some of the issues with the cranks, what can happen, what causes it, and don't be afraid to put power into your twin cam. There are thousands and thousands of twin cam engines out there making good power on the stock crank, and they've been doing it forever without any issues. What I am saying is that you don't want to build it up and be taking it out to the drag strip every weekend and just beating on it, because you're just asking for trouble. And I'm not saying that you got to ride it like a pair of lace panties either. You can get out there and you can ride them like you want to. Just be mindful. So guys, I hope I kind of helped explain what's going on with these crankshafts. You know, if you didn't know, if you just heard that they've had issues with them or there's pressed together crank problems, I hope this gave you some insight into what's really going on with those crankshafts. Now, like I said, the only way to fix it is to either replace it or take it to a machine shop, have it balanced, trued up, and have that crank pin welded. But at the same time, if you're sensible with it, you take care of it, and you ride smart, and you're not just all out beating on it, you should never have a problem with it. But anyhow, guys, I hope the video was helpful. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, please give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. But anyhow, guys, I hope you have a very wonderful new year. Stay safe out there. Dodge the cars on the streets. That's all I've got for you this week, and I look forward to seeing you guys in next week's video. Thank you for watching.